Good afternoon, everyone. Still in the cathedral. Hope you're all having a good day. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Choral Alphabet. It's been a while since we've had one of these programmes, and we left things, well, very much looking forward to Mr. Farmer's Benedictus, which, of course, is the focus for today. We have sung some music by John Farmer before, and he is best known, I think, for his madrigal Fair Phyllis, I Saw Sitting All Alone, one of those great madrigals of the Renaissance era, where the words fa-la-la-la-la tended to sort of occlude more rambunctious participation from the people we're singing about. We're not going to be singing anything as cheeky as that today. It's a beautiful Benedictus in four parts. It's quite low in the register. It's actually written for soprano, for two tenors and bass, though the tenor one line fits the alto line really very well. So looking forward to sharing that with you enormously. And hope you're all having a good day. People are asking about mime and sen, so this is going to be a little sort of adjunct to today's rehearsal, everyone. We will learn the farmer, we'll get to the end, I'll say thank you very much, and then I will start the mime and sen, which we will record today, and then that will be snipped out of today's broadcast and put up as a standalone YouTube video for you to take part in. So there is no requirement for you to record along with today. What I would suggest you do is when we get to the mime and sen bit at the very end, sing along with Jerusalem and Ave Verum Corpus, but wait for us to chop all that together and put it up on the channel for you to record when you have the time, when it's the right occasion for you to get your phone out and to record. So we will record the mime and sen video today, but I won't be expecting people to record along with it live. I hope that makes sense. I think it makes sense. Doesn't quite make sense to me, but I think it'll come good. So let me check everything's working. I'll do a bit more from the old piano today. Good. And we know we've got the acoustics. I left it on at the start of the broadcast. If I press this button, we should have the lovely piece by John Farmer. Great. And if I press this button, we can see the score. Can we hear the recording? Let's make sure it's not too loud. That's a lovely Renaissance word there. Okay, good. I think we've got it working. Let's just check. I'm going to turn this down a bit just so it's not too loud. Here's Jerusalem. Lovely. And the Mozart. This, of course, is going to come at the end. Once we have learnt and sung John Farmer's Benedictus, we will do, as we always do, sing it all the way through. We'll then learn the soprano part, the alto, the tenor, the bass, sing it through again, as it's really very, very short. It's about a minute and a half. I think we'll have plenty of time to do that. Then, as I was just saying, we will put the mime and send, which is a separate little section at the end, so that can be snipped and then edited and put up on YouTube for you to record along with. So I think we're there. Lots of tech today and lots of lovely people in the chat. So I shall say hello to everyone who's here live in a minute, but I want to, as always, welcome everyone who's watching us later on. Thank you so much for making Homechoir part of your very busy lives. And it's so great to see comments and likes and subscriptions and from all sorts of people who have been coming along recently. If you're one of the 40% of people who watches Homechoir's videos and haven't yet clicked the subscribe button, well, please consider subscribing. It is a fantastic channel full of fantastic content, everything from music theory teaching to choral singing to orchestral playing and all sorts of fun besides. We learn sacred music, we learn music hall, we learn gospel and spirituals, we do tongue twisters, and every now and then I write a song based on a ringtone. Well worth subscribing if you haven't done so. And of course, this coming Sunday, the choir is turning three, though our actual celebration for it will be on Monday. Wonderful as it is that we're turning three, I don't feel quite right about turning a Sunday broadcast into an all-singing, all-dancing birthday cake extravaganza. So we'll save that one for Monday. We'll have our Sing Sunday as planned with some lovely music, and then Monday is going to be the birthday bash. So there we go. Let me welcome everyone who's watching live today but isn't necessarily in the live chat. Hello to Helene and Bill and Val in California. I don't know how snowy it is where you are, but it's very snowy here. I woke up this morning to a blanket of snow, said to Anna, I felt like getting the Christmas tree out again and getting presents out for everyone. It's very, very festive. But I do hope everyone out there in California is wrapped up warm and staying safe. Hello to Sue and Tony and Sally and Annie and Maureen. Hello to Anne and Linda and Charlotte and Nikki and Val and Huyen and Katie and to everyone else who is watching but isn't necessarily chatting away today. And then hello everyone over here. A bright and lively crowd here today. So let me welcome you all. I can see here we have nearly 50 people online and more arriving every second. And let me just pop out the list and see who's here. A very good afternoon. Alison, hello Barbara, hello Carolyn, hello Kathy, hello Colette, hello Dorothy, hello Glennis, hello Gwyn, hello Epi, hello Irina, hello Jackie, hello Gwen, hello Jackie, hello Jane. All right, Jen, good to see you. Hello, Jill, good evening to you. Hello, Karen, hello, Kareth. Hello, Kit Kat, hello, Lisa, hello, Marie. Hello to Michael, hello, Mike. Hello, Nicola, hello, Nikki, watching later on. Hello, Patricia, hello, Sheila. Hello, Soraya, hello, Susanna, watching later on. Hello, Terry, hello, Wendy. I see that Atty is here. Hello, Atty, good afternoon to you. And to anyone else, I'd hate to miss anyone off. Hello, Soraya, good afternoon to you. Wonderful. So, how's everyone doing on the comments? Karen's saying, what snow? Oh, there's definitely snow here. Goodness me. Chilly. It's one of those rare days when Bob, our son, agreed with me when I said, you need gloves. He looked out and said, yeah, I need gloves. It's normally a bit of a struggle to get him to remember. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we've got some gorgeous music to learn today. A Benedictus by the Renaissance composer John Farmer. And then at the end of the programme, we're going to record a special little extra bit, which we're going to snip out and turn into what we're calling Mime and Send. More on that in a minute. But let's get started today. We're in the key of F major, so let's sing the F major Homechoir chord. So if you could all choose an F, an A, or a C, and sing it for me, we'll start the show. Nice deep breath, and and the dulcet tones of the home choristers from all around the world. It must mean that we are ready to learn some beautiful music. Welcome, everyone, to the next episode of the Choral Alphabet, Homechoir's unique programme looking at relatively unknown pieces from the choral repertoire. And we're progressing through the alphabet, choosing music by composer in alphabetical order. This week, F is for Farmer, as in John Farmer. And he's an interesting character. We don't know a huge amount about him, but for example, this picture, if you look John Farmer up on the internet, they confidently say this is John Farmer, but other people also say it's Thomas Morley, and someone else says it's William Byrd. So I'm not sure whether this is John Farmer or not, but we do know that he was an important composer of the English madrigal school, particularly known for his work during the Elizabethan period. And you'll probably, if you are a singer of Renaissance music, you'll probably have heard his madrigal, Fair Phyllis, I Saw Sitting All Alone, which we will have a look at in a future session. He was under the patronage of the Earl of Oxford and spent the latter half of his life in Ireland as the Master of Children at Christ Church Cathedral, Dublin, and organist of St. Patrick's Cathedral, also in Dublin. So we're going to learn his marvellous, marvellous Benedictus. But first, a couple of extra little bits and pieces before we get started. We'll warm up. We'll sing Happy Birthday. We don't have any birthdays today, but we do have a birthday tomorrow, and that is Leslie in Chicago. So we will sing Happy Birthday to Leslie in just a minute. Let's get warmed up, shall we? So if I can invite you, please, to stand. Plant your feet a shoulders width apart, make your knees nice and soft, and start to take some nice deep breaths in and out. Wonderful. Nice deep breath and sigh. And again, lovely deep breath and a big deep sigh. Splendid. Roll your shoulders around, everyone. And rolling them back the other way. Lovely. And then bring your shoulders up to your ears, everybody. Take a deep breath. And as you breathe out, let the shoulders fall and relax. Here we go. Splendid. And just roll your head around nice and gently. Stretch the muscles out. If you are regular, you know the drill. Great. Thank you ever so much, everyone. So we'll start here. And we're just going to hum a long note. All right, so hum this F, whichever octave suits you, and breathe whenever you like. Here we go. And... As I said, we're going to sing happy birthday for a dear home chorister who is celebrating her birthday tomorrow. So to dear Leslie in Chicago, thank you so much for being such a wonderful home chorister. Thank you for your lovely singing just the other day with White Choral Bells. I do hope you have a fantastic birthday tomorrow. Let's all sing for Leslie, everyone, after two. Oh, one, two.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Returns of the day, Leslie. Hope you have a cracking birthday. So, everyone, as promised, we're going to be looking today at the lovely piece, the Benedictus by John Farmer. Let's bring that teaching slide back on screen. As I say, is this John Farmer? We don't know. It could be John Farmer, it could be Bird, it could be Thomas Tompkins. I've seen this picture attached to so many. Basically, we're talking about a Renaissance chap who probably wore a ruff and occasionally tights. And who was a prominent composer in the Renaissance era. As we can see here, born around about 1570. Opinion is divided as there are no records. It could actually have been earlier than that, but suffice it to say, he was not long-lived. One of these composers who very tragically died in his early 30s to join composers like Pergolesi and Purcell and Mozart and Mendelssohn and so many others. Now, this lovely piece... The Benedictus. We're actually only going to sing one of the three verses today. We may come back and look at it at a future date. But as a result, the score you've got in the description today and you'll see here on screen is just the first verse. I also want to point out for the basses who might have printed out the score, if you look in bar 18 basses, there is a misprint in the PDF. I've changed it here on screen. In the PDF, there's a G in bar 18, and it should actually be an A. Otherwise, you end up with this chord, which is nice, but it should be that chord. Okay, everyone, so what I want to do is to play it to you all the way through, and then we'll learn soprano, alto, tenor, bass. We'll sing through with the one voice loudest each time, and then we'll sing it all the way through at the end. It's not a very long piece, everyone. It's absolutely lovely, and so here is... John Farmer's Benedictus. Let me give you your notes, basses, tenors, altos, tenor one, and soprano. Here we go, everyone. And...
Oh.
short and sweet, could almost have been an entry in our bite-sized Baroque series last year. So let's start with the soprano sing-through, and everyone else, I should be with you presently. So sops, let's have a look here. It doesn't go desperately high, everyone. It only goes up to a C. So those of you of the alto persuasion would also be very welcome to sing soprano here. Now we start here on middle C, and we sing one, two.
The only Lord of Israel.
Listen again. One, two.
The only Lord of Israel.
Lovely. Sing through these long notes, particularly the ones going across the bar line, everyone. Then we grab a breath and we sing.
Be praised evermore.
Listen again. Sing for me. One, two.
Be praised evermore.
Again, singing through the note.
Ba, 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 da, dum.
So you get that lovely clash and resolution. So let's sing from the beginning, sopranos. The only Lord. One, two.
The only Lord of Israel. Be praised evermore.
Good. Then we go on.
For through his visit.
Now here we are going to say visitation because we have a separate syllable there. Listen to the pitches. Let's sing that together. One, two.
For through his visitation.
Lovely. Then we grab a breath and we sing.
And mercy kept in store.
Sing that with me. One, two.
And mercy kept in store.
Super. Now carrying on. So it goes like this.
His people know he hath redeemed.
Make sure you're warming this sound, as this is a rather lovely piece. One, two.
His people know he hath redeemed.
Super. Carrying on.
That long hath been in thrall.
Nice little line there. Listen to the pitches. Being really careful there at the F sharp. Sing it with me, please, sopranos. Bar 14. One, two.
That long hath been in thrall.
Super. And then a very typical Renaissance harmonic shift. Straight to the minor, so we drop to the D and we sing.
And spread abroad his saving health.
Listen again. Okay, the one thing I'd say before we sing it, just be careful. The note on spread is definitely an F natural rather than an F sharp that we sang in the preceding bar. So I might suggest if you are looking at a paper score and you might just want to mark in a natural sign just by the note there on spread to just remind you that it's just an F natural rather than an F sharp. Let's sing. And spread abroad his saving health. One, two.
And spread abroad his saving health.
And then
upon his servant's
all. Let's sing that together. One, two.
Upon his servant's all.
And that is it. It's a lovely, simple little piece. And so I think what we should do is to sing it all the way through with the sopranos singing more prominently. In fact, what I might do is just have the choir sing and I'll sing this part live. So let's go back to the top. There is our note sopranos. Everyone else, if you want to have a go at sight reading, there are the notes. And let's sing it through with the sopranos. Are you ready? Let's turn the acoustic on after two. One, two.
The only Lord of Israel, be praised evermore.
it. That's the soprano line. Let's go back and have a look at what is written here as the tenor one line, but is actually, of course, an alto part. Now, this might cause a little bit of confusion to you until you get your head around what's going on here, altos. Of course, this is a tenor line, but it is sounding at the same pitch as your regular sort of alto line. So I know it looks high, but everything is down an octave. So your line altos from the start here is 1, 2.
The only Lord of Israel.
Listen again. Let's sing that together. 1, 2.
The only Lord of Israel.
And then.
Be praised evermore.
Listen. With me. 1, 2.
Be praised evermore.
Good. So from the beginning, here we go, starting here. 1, 2.
The only Lord of Israel, be praised evermore.
And then we sing.
For through his visited Zion.
Listen. This next week's a little bit tricky just because there's a wider leap than perhaps we're used to at this point. So it goes. Okay, so listen to that again, starting here.
And mercy kept in store.
Listen to it again. Okay, let me go back. Let's sing that together, please, altos, from And Mercy. After 4, 3, 4.
And mercy kept in store.
Super. Let's go back and let's sing 4 through his visitation. Ready? 1, 2.
4 through his visitation.
Excuse me. Starting there. 1, 2.
4 through his visitation. And mercy kept in store.
Super. Now.
His people now he had redeemed.
Listen. Now note the note on people is pushing against the rest of the choir. So sing out. Sing with me. 1, 2.
His people now he had redeemed.
Super. And then on to the next line.
That long hath been in thrall.
Listen again. Sing for me. 1, 2.
That long hath been in thrall.
Super. Now we sing.
And spread abroad his saving health.
Listen again. So let's sing that together. Ready? 1, 2.
And spread abroad his saving health.
And then to finish.
Upon his servant soul.
Listen again. All right, let's sing that last phrase together. 1, 2.
Upon his servant's soul.
There we are. So, as I say, this is a tenor line, but we're singing it as an alto line today. So whatever's written here on screen, think of it as an octave lower. So let's sing it through as before. I shall sing along, and so we'll make sure we can hear everything. Good. So from the top, there is our note there, tenors. Bear with me, just 2 shakes. That's better. So after 2, nice deep breath. 1, 2. A really nice little line, hopefully comfortable in the range for you all. And if it is a little on the low side, we'll consider singing that soprano line because it doesn't go desperately high, does it? Really? Not really. So let's go back to the top and we'll have a look now at the what's written here as tenor two, but for our purposes today is the tenor line. Let me just double check on those who are here live today. Everything's working. Good, good, good. Okay. So the tenor two line goes like this, and it's quite a low one here today, ladies and gentlemen. So we sing, the only Lord of Israel. Listen. Ready, one, two. The only Lord of Israel. And then, be praised evermore. Listen. Now, carrying on. For through his visitation. Listen. Ready? And. For through his visitation. Fantastic going on. And mercy kept in store. Listen. Two, and mercy kept in store. Super. Then we go up a third to here, and we sing, his people now he had redeemed. Listen. Let's sing that together. One, two. His people now he had redeemed. Excellent. Up the octave. That long hath been in thrall. Listen. Let's sing. That long hath been in thrall. Then the same note. And spread abroad his saving health. Listen again. Lovely. And then. Upon his servant's soul. And upon his servant's soul. Let's just sing that last little bit from And Spread Abroad. This is bar 16, tenor 2, line 1, 2.
And spread abroad his saving health upon his servant's soul.
Lovely. Right, tenors. Back to the top, and let's sing it all the way through. So we've got sopranos there, we've got tenor one, and it's altos today, and tenor two and basses we will look at in just a minute. Okay, so everyone, let's do that one again from the very top. So those notes once more. Bass, tenor, alto, soprano. Nice deep breath. One, two.
The only Lord of Israel, be praised evermore. For through his visitation and mercy kept in store. That long hath been enthralled.
nice tenor line, isn't it? I do like this piece very much. It's low in the range, so that means we can use some of the richer, more sonorous parts of our voice, and particularly now the basses. We've got some really nice rumbly low notes here, everyone. So let's have a look at this first line here. Have a listen to it first. A little bit leapy there, basses, isn't it? And the only Lord of Israel. And then, so listen to that again. Be praised evermore. With me, please, basses. And be praised evermore. Marvellous. Now we go back to the B flat. Listen. Lots of C's and F's there in the second and third bar of that phrase, but we start on the B flat.
For through his visitation.
Let's try that together slowly. One, two.
For through his visitation.
Fantastic. Then carrying on.
And mercy kept in store.
Listen. Sing that together, please, basses. And
mercy kept in store.
Excellent. Up the octave.
His people now he had redeemed.
Listen. Careful on those notes on
now he had redeemed.
Little bit unexpected in a couple of places there. His people, ready, basses. One. To
his people now he had redeemed.
Excellent, then.
That long hath been in thrall.
Listen. Just notice we go back to the C.
That long in thrall.
The note on long and in, it's the same pitch, their basses. After two, one. To
that long hath been in thrall.
Then the same note.
And spread abroad his saving health.
That's tricky as well, listen. Okay, so and spread, one, two.
And spread abroad his saving health.
And then to the end.
Upon his servants all.
With me.
Upon his servants all.
And there is the bass line. If it is a bit low for you, do consider, everyone, then singing either the tenor part, or if the bottom F's are the problem, just go up the octave as you're singing. So let's add that from the top. So those notes again, basses here, tenor, alto, soprano. We're going to have it with the basses, then we're going to have it all the way through with the voices balanced properly. So ready, basses, after two, one, two.
The only Lord of Israel, be praised evermore, for through his visitation. Mercy kept in store, his people now he had redeemed, that long hath been in thrall, and spread abroad his saving health, upon his servants all.
So let's go back to the very beginning. We'll have that once more. And what I'm going to do, you see, this time, is I don't want one part to be louder than all the rest. I'm going to let it play, but I'm going to mime along with this, which is exactly what I shall be asking some of you to do shortly. But for now, let's sing it all the way through from the top. We've got the basses here, tenors, altos and sopranos. Let's have a lovely feel of the Royal Chapel, everyone, as we sing John Farmer's lovely Benedictus. Nice deep breath. One, two. So I really hope you enjoyed learning that gorgeous piece, the Benedictus by the Renaissance composer John Farmer. Now, the choral alphabet will be back in a couple of weeks. Something different is happening next week as I shall be away in Edinburgh, Newcastle. We're going to be rerunning some of those classic deep dives, looking at works like Mozart's Requiem and Rachmaninoff's Vespers next week. But the week after, we shall be back where G, I think, is going to be possibly for Gibbons. We'll see. All right, now, that would normally be the end of the broadcast, but today is something a bit different. We have been asking you behind the scenes to record the sing and sends for our upcoming performance on April the 23rd. And what we're going to do now, everyone, is we are going to just capture the video for what we are calling Mime and Send. So you don't have to record along with this live stream now, but everything that follows is going to form the basis of the video that will guide you through the Mime and Send recordings, okay? So don't worry about recording along with this live, although what I'm going to do now is start talking about singing this live. So just bear with me 2 moments, everyone, just while I get the presentation up on screen. And do take the opportunity, please, folks, to grab a drink and get hydrated. Okay, so here we go. Let's go to Mime and Send. So everyone, welcome to Mime and Send. Thank you in advance for all of the recordings that you're sending us for the Sing and Send. This bit is nothing to do with the audio. This is about the video that's going to go along with both Jerusalem and the Ave Verum Corpus when we perform with the City of Bristol Brass Band and the University of the West of England Singers at Bristol Grammar School at 3 o'clock on the 23rd of April. So what is Mime and Send and how is it different to Sing and Send? Well, you're going to mime along with the recordings for Jerusalem and Ave Verum Corpus. You're going to record yourself using probably your phone or your tablet, and you're going to send it in. We're not going to use the audio from this. We're just going to use the video, and we're going to match it to the audio that you're already recording. So what do we need from you? Well, obviously, we need a video, which you can record using your phone, you can record using your tablet, but this is absolutely vital to make sure, everyone, that you record the right type of video, and therefore you can be included in this fantastic project. So first of all, do your best, if you can, to have no headphones visible. Okay? So we don't want to see headphones if possible. Secondly, please wear what you like, okay? Be comfortable, but try and avoid visible logos. And please don't worry about colour coordinating across different sections, because we're going to place you in different parts of the screen depending on the type of video you record for us. So please don't worry about colour coordinating. I don't want all the altos in red and all the sopranos in blue and so on. That would just confuse matters. Please record. This is vital in portrait mode. So I am here on the screen in portrait mode. This is portrait mode for me. This is landscape mode. So what we want, everyone, is portrait. Okay, think passport photo rather than landscape photography. Okay, so portrait mode is essential. If in doubt, just hold your phone the way you normally would, like that. And please remember to smile. Okay, you are here to enjoy yourselves when you're singing along or miming along. Do remember to try and look happy when you can, okay? Because that's going to be really engaging and appealing. We don't want to see a screen full of people not enjoying themselves, Okay, if I want to see that, so I can just turn on the live feed from the British House of Parliament. Now, please, where possible, use a plain background. So my background here would not be ideal for this scenario. What I'd need to do is to find a patch of wall or a curtain or something and film myself with that as the backdrop. And try, if you can, folks, to light yourself properly. We've suggested two or more sources. So the window, providing a bit of general ambient light and maybe a lamp on your face, just so we can see you. All right. Now, I appreciate that's quite a lot to bear in mind. But all of that will go towards making this a really very appealing project, and we'll make sure that you can be included in the final video. Now, there is a Dropbox link in the description of this video, so please use that Dropbox link at the end to send us your recording. Now, for those of you who are going to record your video along with this session, if I could ask you to get your phone ready, and some people watching at the moment are not ready to do this, and that's fine. You can pause and come back when you're ready to record. Have your phone ready. What we're going to do is I shall ask you to press record in a minute, and then we are going to mime along with our first song, which is Jerusalem. Now, what I'm going to do is, just to show you, I'm going to put the words up on screen so you don't have to worry about following scores. You can look straight at the words and sing and enjoy your performance. And remember, try and avoid headphones if you can. So everyone, if you're going to record along with today's video, can I ask you to press record now? Fantastic. And so here are your words, and let's mime together, ladies and gentlemen. Here is Jerusalem. Fantastic. Well done, everyone. So you can press stop on your recording if you're recording along with this session. Roll your shoulders around. That's one done. Do you know what? I find it so much easier to sing when I'm miming. Do you know what? No problems with breathing. It's an absolute doddle. Just remember, when you are recording along with these things, remember to look happy. Where possible, look into the camera when you're not singing. That's usually, if you're singing along with your phone, that's the little dots at the top rather than into the screen. Just to give you an example, those of you watching live, if I go full screen, if I look into the camera, it's like I'm looking at you, whereas if I look at the screen, you can see it's not as engaging. So that's a little tip. And if you are recording on something and you want to really make sure you're making eye contact with the camera, remember the little trick of putting some little sticky eyes either side of the camera. Make sure it's not over the camera. Okay, but then you can look straight at the eyes of your fellow home choristers and sing for them. So that is one of the two mime and sends today, everyone. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to put the words back on screen. So I'm going to ask you to press record in just a moment. Here are the words for Ave Verum Corpus. Remember, all we want is miming. We don't need you to sing. If you would like to sing along with the notes on screen, remember we did a recording of that and we can put that up again separately for you. But for today, I just want Ave, Ave Verum Corpus and so on. So if I could ask you to get your devices ready, those of you who are going to record, please press record on your video recorder now. Wonderful. And let us enjoy the Mozart Ave Verum Corpus. Here we go, folks. If I could ask you to please press stop on your recording device now. Let's put that back up on screen. So please press stop. And what we need you all to do, please, is to send us the links, send us the files via the choir Dropbox. The links are in the description. You can also find that on our website. If you go to the Sing and Send page, scroll down to Mime and Send. All the information you need has been painstakingly put on the website by Anna. So please make sure you familiarise yourself with that. Send us the video files. And just huge thanks to all of you. It's such a pleasure, not just to hear you, but in these occasions to actually see you singing along. It's been a while since we've made a video where the choir is actually singing. singing. I think the last one was Let Justice and Judgment, which was 2 years ago. So it's about time that we saw you and heard you sing. So thank you to everyone for taking part. And please remember, the more of you that take part, the better. The end result is going to be fabulous. So lots going on here. And thank you, everyone, for your flexibility and your understanding. In fact, we have massively overrun. I really do hope you enjoyed learning that lovely piece of John Farmer and, of course, had fun with Mime and Send. Join me on Fun Friday as we sing a piece called Won't You Come Home, Bill Bailey, and more jazzy songs besides. And then, of course, sing Sunday with some more glorious music. Whatever you got planned for the rest of today, I hope it goes very well. If you, like we, are snowed in, well, wrap up warm and stay safe. Whatever happens, folks, just enjoy the next few days, and I look forward to seeing you on Friday. All the very best. Take care. Bye-bye.